Hello everybody. We will study silkworm diseases. There are various species of the silkworm, of which four important species are mulberry silkworm, airy silkworm, muga silkworm, and tusser silkworm. But there is no silkworm race or species at present which is totally resistant to diseases. Silkworm is susceptible to a number of diseases. Diseases are of four major types depending upon the pathogen. If the pathogen is protozoan, then it is called as Pebrine disease. Bacterial pathogen will cause Flacheri, viral will cause Gracery, and fungal will cause Muscardine disease. Let us first deal with the protozoan disease of silkworm. It is also called as Pebrine. It is most destructive disease of the silkworm. The causative organism or pathogen of this is protozoan parasite Nosema vomicis. The spores of the pathogen are oval, bright, bluish, and about 3 to 5 micron in size. These can be easily detected under microscope. The mode of infection of this disease is because of ingestion of spores of Nosema. The disease is transmitted to silkworm in 3 different ways: oral, contact, and transovarial. The oral transmission, the main source is food contaminated with spores. The larvae, when ingest contaminated food, get infected. Later, this infection spreads from gut to other parts of the body by autoinfection. The second route is contact. The eggs may be contaminated by fecal matter or dead tissues containing the spores at the time of oviposition or egg laying or after oviposition. Larvae may get infected through their skin from the rearing bed contaminated with Nosema spores containing fecal matter or dead tissue. The third route is transovarial transmission. As the name indicates, it is transmitted through the ovary of the mother moth. If infection occurs in the 5th instar stage, you know there are 5 stages of the larva in the life cycle of the silk moth. The last larval stage is 5th instar. From that, the pupa will form. The adult moth normally emerges through this pupal stage. The spores of Nosema ingested then reaches reproductive organs, sporulate within the oocyte, and pass on to the eggs. Such eggs hatches into primary infected larvae. Infected eggs hatch in very low percentage, and the hatched out larvae usually die before reaching 3rd instar. These larvae act as the source of secondary infection for other larvae through their feces or dead tissues. On the basis of source of infection, the Pebrine can be divided into 2 types, hereditary and contaminative. The hereditary Pebrine is the infection in the seed obtained from deceased mothers. That means when the adult moth is infected, then due to transovarial transmission, these spores will go into the eggs and it will pass into the next generation. So the eggs are infected and the larvae hatched out from such eggs are with the spore of the pathogen. Contaminative Pebrine is caused to the originally healthy worm ingesting infected material. Symptoms. In eggs, the pebrinized eggs are deficient in sticking power, hence they get easily detached from the egg cards. The eggs are one over another, that is in lumps instead of side by side. Hatching of such eggs is irregular. A pebrinized laying usually includes unfertilized and dead eggs. These are the pictures showing pebrinized eggs. The normal eggs lie side by side, while pebrinized eggs lie one over the other, forming lumps. Symptoms in worms or larvae. The larvae become sluggish and dull. Feeding of the larvae is affected as larvae have poor appetite and they cease to feed. It affects molting and growth of the larvae, which becomes irregular. Molting is casting of the cuticle. So during growth of the larvae, the larva molts, means it casts of the cuticle and grows. So that molting becomes irregular. As a result, growth is irregular. Therefore, in a rearing tray, you can observe the larvae of unequal size. The worm appears paler and more translucent than the healthy worm. Appearance of dark brown or black pepper spots on the body of the worm is the characteristic symptom of this disease. So in the picture, you can see the normal larvae and febrile larvae. So the dark brown or black pepper-like spots are present on the larval body, and therefore this disease is also called as febrile disease. After the fourth stage, the larval skin gets wrinkled. Infected larvae spits its silk in irregular masses. Normally, the larva gives silk in a uniform thread and it spins it regularly around the body, but the infected larvae spits all of its silk in irregular masses and there is wastage of silk. In severe infection, larvae may spin poor and flimsy, that means thin cocoon, or may die before spinning. In symptoms in the pupae, swelling and unusual softening of the abdominal parts, pupil movements become dull, the color gets dark, black spots may appear on the sides of the body, improper metamorphosis, so meta means change, morphosis means morphology, so change in the morphology is improper, that means the molting is irregular and growth is irregular, the development of the larvae is affected. Pupae are unfit for seed. Symptoms in moths or adults. The scales fall off easily, forming bare patches on the body. So because of falling of the scales, there are patches of on the body where scales are lacking. Scales get discolored. The wings do not stretch fully and are deformed. The belly swells and the moth does not move freely. The egg-laying capacity of the moth is poor. Prevention and control measures. Use of disease-free seeds of mother moth. Surface sterilization of disease-free seeds by dipping the egg cards in 2% formalin for 20 minutes and then washing with running water. Thorough disinfection of rearing room and equipment with 2% formalin, followed by sun drying of equipment. During rearing, unequal and unmolted larvae should be examined for infection and removed, followed by disinfection of the tray. Avoid overlapping of the larvae during rearing. Dead eggs, larvae, pupae, and moths should all be removed from the culture. The second type of this is bacterial disease of silkworm. It is also called as flachery. The flachery can be defined as a group of diseases associated with the pathogenic bacteria. The main causes for incidence of flachery are overcrowding of the larvae, overfeeding of the larvae, dirty, dry, or wet and fermented leaves, leaves not suited to the age of the larvae. So during culturing of the larvae, the particular quality and quantity of leaves are required depending upon the age of the larvae. For example, the young stage larvae require tender leaves, while as the larvae grow, more quantity of leaves are required, and at the later stages of development, more mature leaves are required. High temperature or high humidity and bad ventilation. So the temperature requirement for rearing of the larvae is 25 to 27 degrees centigrade and humidity should be maintained at 70 to 80%. Temperature higher than the required and humidity also higher than the required will prone for the bacterial diseases. Depending on the causal agents and symptoms, flatulence is classified as bacterial diseases of digestive organs, septicemia or hemolymph disease, Sotto disease or nerve center. Bacterial diseases of digestive organs, the pathogens are different at different infective stages. In the initial stage of development, the streptococci-like bacteria are responsible for the bacterial disease. In the late stage of development, Bacillus coli is the pathogen. In the moribund stage, means half-died stage, the protease-like bacteria is responsible for these bacterial diseases. The mode of infection is because of faulty rearing or oral consumption of infected leaves. The symptoms of the disease is loss of appetite, sluggishness, slow growth, inelasticity of the skin, and softening of the body. The bacteria multiplies in the digestive tract of the worm and destroys the membranous tissue of the intestine. As the gut is infected, it leads to diarrhea and the worm passes out soft excrement with the membrane of intestine as a jointed beads. The worm vomits blackish fluid and becomes restless. It wriggles due to pain. The body putrefies and becomes black or green. So these are the pictures of the flatulence attacked larvae showing soft and loose skin and the dead larva with black skin after flatulence. Prevention and control. Select disease resistance variety of worm. Incubate the eggs properly so that the healthy worms will emerge out. Care should be taken during feeding to avoid overfeeding, feeding of overmature or withered leaves and overcrowding. During rearing, the overfeeding should be avoided and also overcrowding of the larva. That means proper spacing of the larva should be maintained. Otherwise, the larvae will get infected. The spacing required is different at different stages. For example, if you start with a single tray of the larva, first instar, by the time it reaches fifth instar stage, the number of trays should be increased to 5 to 9 in number. So that care should be taken to avoid overcrowding of the larva and for giving proper spacing. The spacing required ranges from 0.2 square meter for the first instar larva up to 18 square meter for the fifth instar larva. Proper disinfection and maintenance of hygienic conditions during rearing is the effective preventive measure. Disinfect rearing room and equipment with 2% formalin solution or lime and bleaching powder mixture in 2:1 proportion. Unequal sized infected and dead worms should be removed from the culture and destroyed. The third bacterial disease is septicemia. The disease is caused by penetration and multiplication of bacteria in the hemolymph. The pathogen for the disease are large bacilli, small bacilli, streptococci, staphylococci. Mode of infection. Infection occurs through injured part of the skin. Bacteria of the digestive tract may enter through the membranous cells of the gut or alimentary canal and penetrate into the body fluid, that is called as hemolymph. The symptoms of the disease is a typical symptom is loss of clasping power of the prolegs. The worm vomits brown fluid. It passes liquid excrement. The dead worm becomes black and emits foul odor. The four intestine part of the body may be swell and the posterior part shrunks in dead larva. Disinfection of appliances and rearing room with 2% formalin solution must be done after each rearing to prevent the disease. Care should be taken during handling the worms so that they will not get injured. So when you transfer the larvae from one tray to other, from one bed to other, you should use the net and should not use the needle or forceps to transfer the larvae, because the larvae may get injured. So that care should be taken during handling the worms. Infected worms should be removed and destroyed by burning or burying deep in the soil. Next disease is the Sotto disease. The pathogen is Bacillus thuringiensis. Mode of infection is ingestion of toxic substance released by the bacteria. The symptoms of the disease are the toxin is absorbed through the gut wall and affects nerve center. As the nervous tissue is affected, the worm becomes restless, shows vigorous irregular movements, convulsions, which leads to paralysis of the worm. Dead worm becomes dark in color. The inner organs of the body are liquefied. The skin cracks and a black liquid with foul odor oozes or comes out of the body. Prevention and control of the disease. Disinfection of rearing room and equipment with 2% formalin. Infected worms should be removed and destroyed. The next type of silkworm disease is viral diseases, also called as Grasseri. Due to yellow color assumed by the affected worm, it is also called as jaundice. The pathogen for viral disease is Borrelia virus. The mode of infection is ingestion of contaminated food. The virus passes through intestinal wall into the body cavity of the worm and invade the cells of susceptible tissues. Disease can be induced by subjecting worms to very low or high temperature. So as I mentioned, the proper temperature should be maintained. The low or high temperature can induce the disease. Irregular feeding with tender and mature leaves favors incidence of Grasseri. So at particular age of the larva, particular quality and quantity of leaves should be given to avoid the induction of the disease. Types of Grasseri. The virus forms polyhedral bodies of 5 to 6 facets. It is of two types, cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus, also called CPV, and nuclear polyhedrosis virus or NPV. The cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus is transmitted through oral route or by induction due to bad environment. The virus invades cytoplasm of the cell. It is hexagonal in shape. Symptoms of the disease. The disease is also called as Kenchu disease. The infected worm shows stunted growth. The worm becomes pale yellow and discharges whitish feces. Polyhedra completely fill the cytoplasm and destroy the cell. The head of the worm becomes larger than the rest of the body. The last instar infected worms form flimsy or thin cocoons. The dead larvae shows brownish patches. Polyhedra passes out along with feces and the infection is spread. Nuclear polyhedrosis virus or NPV. It is rod-shaped species of Borrelia. It enters the nucleus of the cell and multiplies. The polyhedral bodies are formed in the nuclei of adipose tissue, tracheal membrane cells. So trachea are the part of respiratory organs of the insect, blood cells or silk gland cells. NPV can be transmitted by the following routes. First is oral. Ingestion of leaves contaminated with polyhedrosis virus from the dead tissue of feces from infected worms. Environment, high temperature, humidity, etc. may induce the spreading of this disease. Blockage of spiracles, contaminated leaves with formalin, exposure to camphor during rearing and blocking of spiracles by dust may induce the disease. Spiracle is the part of respiratory organ of the insect. Skin wound. The worm may get infection from contaminated rearing bed. If the body of the worm is injured, then the virus will enter inside the body cavity of the worm. The symptoms of the disease. About a week after infection, the swelling appears first at the first segment of the infected larva. The swelling gradually extends along the entire body. The swelling is much pronounced at the intersegment, giving the worm the nodded appearance like a bamboo. So the picture shows the bamboo-like appearance on the body of the larva. Skin gets stretched and fragile. The worm fails to molt and crawls aimlessly. The skin ruptures and yellowish or white fluid oozes from the ruptured places. If the last instant worm is infected with Gracilli, it spits and wastes its silk or spins flimsy cocoon. It dies inside the cocoon before becoming pupa, means it will not form the pupal stage. Prevention and control. Thorough disinfection of equipment and rearing room. Surface sterilization of eggs by dipping egg cards in 2% formalin and then washing with running water. Rearing of larvae under hygienic conditions. Maintenance of proper temperature and humidity. Provide constant fresh air circulation. The silkworm should be handled carefully so as to avoid any injury to them. Provide sufficient spacing between the larvae according to their age so as to avoid overcrowding. Careful removal of infected larvae and their destruction. Keep larval bed thin and dry, especially during rainy season. Application of RKO, that is Reshim Kit Aushad, on the worms before brushing and after each molt before feeding. So this Reshim Kit Aushad is available in the market. When the worms are transformed from egg sheet on the rearing bed, the brush is used, and therefore before brushing, this RKO should be applied to the rearing bed, and also after each molt or before feeding, the proper disinfection should be done. Formalin disinfectant is also helpful to inactivate the polyhedral body. The next pathogen is fungus. So the fungal diseases of silkworm are also called as muscardine. And these muscardine are of four types: white muscardine, green muscardine, yellow, and brown. The pathogen for white muscardine disease is Beveria bassiana. For green muscardine, Spicaria prasina. For yellow muscardine, Isaria farinos. And for brown muscardine, Aspergillus species. Of these, white muscardine is most common in India. The mode of infection. The fungal conidia, when came in contact with the skin of the worm, germinates. The germinating tube penetrates the skin and enters inside the body. It grows into mycelium, which comes in contact with the body fluid of the worm and forms cylindrical spores. The fungus continues its development in the body cavity. This is the picture of typical fungus. So it has mycelia, conidiophore, which gives conidia, and from conidia spores are formed. So this conidiophore mycelium grows inside the body cavity of the worm. The conidia germinate in the blood and penetrate the adipose tissue, muscles, nervous system, silk gland, etc. So blood means hemolymph of the worm. In the advanced state of infection, the circulation stops and the worm dies. Dead larva spreads the infection. The symptoms of this disease are the infected larvae lose appetite and become inactive. It oozes out irregular oily specks on the skin. The larvae have diarrhea and vomits fluid. The body loses elasticity. The larva dies within 3 to 5 days of infection. The body hardens and becomes stiff. The body is covered with white, yellow, green, or brown mycelia according to the species or pathogen. Numerous conidia on the body together appear as powdery substance. If the last insta larvae are infected, it may form cocoon, but the pupa will not form. If pupa is infected, it becomes hard and dries. So the picture shows white muscadine. The entire larva is covered with chalky substance. If the muscadine is brown, then brown specks appear on the body. If it is green, then green colored specks appears on the body. Prevention and control. Thorough disinfection of equipment and rearing room during the course of rearing. Surface sterilization of eggs by dipping egg cards in 2% formalin and then washing with running water. Rearing of larvae under hygienic conditions. Maintenance of proper temperature and humidity are effective prevention measures. Infected larvae should be removed using net and destroyed. So instead of picking larvae with the forceps, the net method should be used to remove the infected larvae. Use of bed disinfectants like formalin chap or resham kit aushad. Disinfection of the rearing room and equipment between consecutive rearing. So overall summary of silkworm diseases is there are 4 types of pathogens causing disease in the silkworm. These are protozoan, bacterial, viral, and fungal. Accordingly, the protozoan pathogen is called pebrine, bacterial is flacheri, viral is grasseri, and fungal muscadine disease. The pathogen for protozoan disease is Nosema bombicis. The bacterial diseases are of 3 types. One is of digestive system, the other is hemolymph, and third is nerve center. In the digestive system, there are 3 types of pathogen. In the first stage of infection, streptococci-like pathogen. In the late stage of infection, Bacillus coli is the pathogen. And in the moribund stage, Proteus-like pathogen. Hemolymph, the infection is because of staphylococci. In the nerve center, the pathogen is Bacillus thuringiensis. The viral disease is also called as Grasseri. The pathogen is Borrelina virus. It is of 2 types, the cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus and nuclear polyhedrosis virus. The fungal disease is also called as muscadine. There are 4 types of fungi, white, green, yellow, and brown. The white muscadine is because of Beveria bassiana. Green muscadine is because of Spicaria prasina. Yellow muscadine is due to Isaria farinose, and brown is because of Aspergillus species. Thank you.